What a treat to have the Unity North Band. Thank you all so much. Well, good morning, Unity North. Come on, good morning, Unity North. All right, there we go. So I was thinking this week that every time we come here, whatever day of the week, whatever event is happening, it is a treat. No tricks, just treat. Every time we walk through these doors. Well, today, you're in for a double treat because you get your normal treat, and it's Choir Sunday, everybody. Give it up for the choir. Give it up for the choir. They have worked so hard. The songs are so beautiful. So we can't wait for you to feel the music down in your soul. So much so, that's gonna be our opening song. We're gonna feel the music down in our soul. So on your feet, if you're able, open your hearts and your minds, and together let us feel the music down in our soul.
Good morning, Unity North, and welcome home. Welcome to the wide world. Welcome to the connection of oneness that we feel with all people today, worshiping in temples, in stone circles, in mosques, in churches everywhere. Take your hand. We're going to be doing this a lot today. Take your hand and place it upon your heart. And say it with me, I am home. You know, we're a small group this morning, but where two or more are gathered in the name of home, home is there. Yes? Let home be there in our opening prayer today as we take a deep breath together and we exhale. And the exhale, we release anything that would keep us from being home in mind and heart and spirit, in truth and in body. We allow ourselves to feel the oneness with those on the stream, with those in the room, and those that we've never met that are right now this day finding their way home. We give thanks that we're all walking a path to home, and we're listening to that inner music, that music that is calling each of us individually and collectively to the highest and deepest vibration of truth. And so, yes, we are home today, and we say thank you, God, for each person, the gift that they brought into this room. Thank you, God, doing business as this community, those that are online, those that are in the room, and those that are still to find us. Let us breathe into the space. Let us listen to the music. Let us hear the music of those others, and let us feel it as the whole. That is the presence and the power of God, the one power and one presence made manifest here and now as home. For this and so much more, we are grateful, and we say thank you, God. Thank you, God. Together, thank you, God. And so it is, and so we let it be. Amen. All right, Julie, we got some stuff going on. Let's hear about it.
Amen. Thank you. So I want to welcome everybody out there, too, while we get started, and welcome to you in here. We have indeed a lot going on. So our first thing is we have a very important congregational meeting on November 7th. I believe that is next Sunday. We are going to be voting and talking about some pretty big expenditures, and we want your input. We need your vote. If you are a member and need to verify your membership, you can do that online. You can do it that day, but we prefer you do it ahead of time. So that meeting is next Sunday, November 7th at 1 p.m. in the sanctuary. This is a live meeting because we need a vote and a quorum. So please, please, please plan to attend that meeting. Unity Basics and Conscious Community is coming up. These are the classes that you need to become a member. Or if you'd like a refresher about our new thought and Unity principles, you can sign up for those classes online. The Unity Basics Part 1 is November 13th. It is on Zoom, 10 a.m. November 13th. Register online. And then Part 2, we have a slide, November 15th, so a couple days later, at 7 p.m. on Zoom. Register online for that. Our annual pet blessing is coming up November 14th. That's a Sunday, and weather permitting, we're going to be having that at our beautiful labyrinth. And so we want to invite you to bring your well-behaved, leashed pets. We will take lizards. We will take a well-kept llama, dogs, and cats. This is one of our most cherished events that we do. And Marquita's our new head of the pet ministry, and Reverend Richard will be there. And we're blessing the pets, but as we know, really the pets are blessing us. And so please join us at 2 p.m. November 14th at the Labyrinth. You have just enough time to get some lunch and grab your pet and head back. Finally, Friday night was our fall festival. How many people were here for our fall festival? Yes. Yes, we wanted it to be outside, and yes, we are flexible because we know that in all things there is fun, there is good. So we moved it inside. So I just want to thank Nicole Glasgow, our program chair, Marissa Enzel, who was the chair of the event, and all of the ministries. One of the best parts of the night was seeing all of the ministries who took on that scavenger hunt station, and we were in community. We had lots of kids and families. We had some new families that found us through Next Door, which we are just so happy about. So if you were a ministry and you did a table, please raise your hand so we can give you a nice round of applause. How many people? Yes, we've got Pet, we have the women, Men of Unity. Everybody was here. There's lots of pictures online, so you can go and see. If you missed it, we invite you to not miss the next one. Now, the scavenger hunt, one of the best parts of it, was we have a $50 gift card for everyone who completed the scavenger hunt. We had about 65 teams, which I think was really good considering we had to move it inside at the last minute. So I'm going to have Will dig down deep and pick the winner of our $50 gift card. No cheating. Woohoo! Let's see.
Will Hogg.
Jay Schofield, what, if you are in the house, I'm assuming he went around and did the whole hunt. I've got your gift card if you're here today. If not, we'll have it in the office. But $50 goes to Jay. So again, we are just so happy to be able to provide these events. When you're tithing and doing your love offering, keep that in mind, that so many people had to be in place to provide that. And this year with COVID, we've had to be creative, and I think we've done so in spades. So that's it for me.
All right, thanks, Julie. We want to welcome anybody who's here for the very first time today, whether you be online for the first time or in the room for the first time. You've brought a gift to us. A little bit of music will be great. Ryan, just behind it. We behold you as the light of God that you are. Here at Unity North, we don't see anybody as broken or stained or needing fixing. We're just waking up together. And we're glad that you have brought your presence into the room to wake up with us today. And there's a crossing of the paths, our path and your path. We honor all the paths to God, but in that intersection, something beautiful happens. And I hope that something beautiful happens for you today. And I'd like to talk to you and meet you after the service. I'll be right out in the foyer right afterwards. But right now, those of you online, you can raise your hand as well. If you're here for the first time, we just want to give you a warm welcome with a round of applause to let you know how grateful we are that you are here today. Anybody here or online for the first time? Oh, come on, make a little bit of noise. So, we know that somebody's watching for the very first time, and we welcome you. We're sending over the airwaves our love and our commitment to you. I do want to ask the question, who is here brand new? Absolutely born anew into the magnificent expression and spirit of God that we know you to be. Who's coming into the room with a brand new heart and a new mind? Yes? That's something to celebrate, and we celebrate that with you. So the theme today is all about listening to the music within us, and this is the first time we've had any kind of a choir. It's been a group that's been working with masks on. I was in rehearsal the other night saying, I don't know why I can't hear you. Well, because we were all wearing masks to rehearse, which makes it really interesting. This is really the first time we're going to be singing without masks on, so God knows what we're going to hear. But I know it's going to be beautiful. I know it's going to be fantastic, and these people have been working really hard to get that choir back to the 80 members that we used to have. You join me in that intention? We're building on a foundation of some really dedicated people. This song is called Listen to the Music Within Me.
Others
Thank you. I forgot one thing. If you have children in our Unikids program today, you're going to be in for a treat later in service. And I forgot to tell you that we will be releasing your kids from up here at the balloon. So when service is over, please go there. And that's for our birth to fifth grade. So stay tuned for them later.
Releasing kids, it sounds like they're in jail. Let's take a moment and join me, and let's send some love to all the kids downstairs. And this floor moves. Don't be afraid. Just send a bit of love. Send it love. We are connected to them. Space and time does not separate us from the youth. Even though we may look like we're older, we are still kids at heart. Yes? As we listen to the music that has been in our heart and in our soul, as our heart and as our soul since the beginning of time, we're 1 second, one thought, one moment, one feeling away from returning to the symphony that is our lives. Yes? This is the final talk in a 5-part series based on dream building, on taking the energies that have been placed into our hands to create heaven on earth, to create our lives individually as heaven on earth, our community as heaven on earth, and our common humanity. All the power of the universe has been placed between our two ears and right here at the center of our heart as music, a great duet between head and heart that is manifesting everything that we could ever desire, every dream, every vision. And we've shared a lot of words over the last 5 weeks. A lot of words, a lot of ideas, a lot of quotes, a lot of PowerPoints, a lot of theories about how to do that. It's been wonderful. It's been great. It's been impassioned. It's been full of vibrance and energy and excitement. In fact, last week, I think it kind of came to a culmination. I watched the talk, and I was like, boy, I was electric with what was happening in this congregation, and electric with what was happening within the lives of each member of this congregation. Today, I'm going to take an exhale. Exhale with me. I'm going to ask you several times during the course of the message to place your hand upon your heart. Not now. You can do it now. You can do it the whole time if you want, because that's where the music resides. Rather than offer you a bunch of theories, there's no PowerPoints today. There's no quotes today, but I'm going to share some stories from the level of the music that I have received since coming onto the planet and 59 years of finding my song. 59 years, hopefully, of everybody finding who they are and what they are. It says in Scripture, on the seventh day, God rested. Sabbath. Sabbath. We've had 6 ideas that we have shared over the course of these 5 weeks. Important ideas, technical knowledge of how to take the possibility from mind and bring it into the manifest realm. But on the seventh day, God rested, and I think maybe we need to rest a little bit. Exhale once again with me. The final step, and actually it's the first step that precedes all of the other steps, is a place of Sabbath, a place of connection, a place of remembering. So I've come down off the platform. I promised the camera crew I wasn't going to wander too much. I want to keep it really simple today, and I wanted to be close to the music of your hearts and your souls and not so far away on a platform. Our 6 steps, belief in the possible. Any dream that's ever been on the planet or ever will be began with a belief. Step 1, day 1, it's possible. Step number 2 is I have to have a knowing that it's already done in the mind of God. I have to completely understand and know at the depth of who I am that that which I'm seeking is already done in the mind of God. It already exists. Number 3, I need to have a love for the creative process. I need to love that which is calling for expression in me at such a deep place that I step into the creative process and take an action. Step number 4, I get busy in accord with spiritual truth, putting my body behind the vision, my body behind the ideas, putting love in action through my body. Step number 5 was stretching. We cannot create the next version of ourselves. We can't live into the symphony of ourselves until we have stretched ourselves out of the comfort zone. There's more music of you to unfold. There's more music of you to be, and the world is waiting, standing at the door, knocking, saying, come on out. As we talked about last week, that's going to require an investment. An investment of your time, your energy, your talent, your resources, your thoughts, your feelings. Your whole life is invested in that possibility. That was step 6, but you do it from a consciousness of overflow, of more than enough. Do we really believe in a finite universe or an infinite universe? The mindset that we have behind our investment will determine what kind of world we're going to live on the outside. Brandy is up on the stage right now. She's investing her time, her energy, and her talent, her prayers, her heart, her mind, and her soul for one purpose today. That's to hold the highest and best for you. Our chaplains, that's what they do. Your dream is being built today, and you have a partner in believing sitting on the stage. She would love to pray with you after the service in the back of the room or right up here to take it to the next level of your investment in what God can do through you and what God can do as you. Today, we come to the seventh step, the seventh day of creation, a Sabbath. Exhale once again, and this time place your hand upon your heart. All the pretty ideas, all the pretty theories, all the wonderful, powerful notions that we have shared must come to a place where they live so deeply within us that the words are now no longer needed. We feel the music within us before the song ever manifests. You've got to feel the music and feel it come from deep within. You've got to feel the music before the singing can begin. You gotta know that way down deep inside is where you're gonna give your music life. Feel the music and everything will be all right. All dreams, every dream, past, present, and future, is finding its roots, its source, its foundation in one place. Listening to the music within you. The music of the hero's call. The call to create meaning, to find meaning, to create purpose, and to leave your mark upon this earth, because this dream is not just for you. Your music is not just for you. To hold it and keep it as your own would be a bit selfish. It is for the world to become what the world can be, humanity to become what it can be. So the song must be shared. But first, before the song has life, you've got to feel it. Leave your mark upon the world. Somebody who made a mark on my life, my first story for the day. Music. My grandmother pulled me off the baseball field when I was 11 years old. You've heard about her. I've shared this story, but it bears repeating because she lives in me. And my grandmother took me to the piano, and she showed me technically, through the portal of my mind, how to play music at the piano. She taught me how to hold my hands correctly. She taught me how to figure out the rhythms. She taught me how to read the music, and I hated her for it. Music was not coming through the portal of my head. It was not coming through the portal of my intellect. She did a very good job of teaching me the technical aspects of making music, but I just didn't receive it. I didn't like it. And any piano teacher will tell you today, Kiki will tell you, that I still don't hold my hands right. But the reality is she didn't reach me, teaching me the technical aspects of music. So she took me off the piano, and she went over to the record player, and my grandmother put on records of Chopin. And she played beautiful music of Chopin. And I would love to say that was the moment that I became the musician that I am today. It was not. I appreciated the beautiful music. But that moment that was so sacred to me was not the music of Chopin, but it was watching my grandmother receive the music of Chopin. My grandmother could be very uptight. She was wound very, very tight. And it showed up in her body. My grandmother had crippling arthritis. But when she put a record player on, I watched my grandmother transform before my eyes. The tense face, the tense hands began to melt. And I watched her receive this beautiful classical music. That was the moment music began to be awakened in me. It had nothing to do with the listening to the music or the technical aspects of music, but it was being touched by another human being who could let that music out and awaken within her a softening. My grandmother was more beautiful in that moment than she had ever been when I watched her from the baseball field, I watched her from the piano, or I wanted to pull my hair out because she was so tense about you gotta go to college, and if you don't go to college, you're nobody. But I saw my grandmother for the first time, and it was so incredibly beautiful. She was transported to another dimension. I, in that moment, became a better musician. But I have carried that view, that idea, into every other area of my life. And as I count the number of people that live within me as I do ministry, my Grandma Burdick is right at the top. Because the principles that she applied at the piano, at the record player, apply in a church. The spirituality that I have found, I knew at some point on my walk to find God, to create heaven on earth, to be the very best version of light that I could be, to have the dream that was mine to do, and to be the minister of a church, I had to listen deeply because I couldn't do it of myself. I am kind of wound tight a little bit too. I come by it naturally. I see the heads going, oh yeah, you are. And I don't think it's an accident. Thank God I'm not crippled with arthritis, but I get little reminders in my body that I am related to my grandmother. And I can take medication for it, but the medication I take for my arthritis is to make sure I pause once a day and listen to the music. You see, what we do here at Unity North is listen to the music of each other, which is the music of God. Our job is to vibrate at the level of God music, which is above and beyond the intellect. All the words for the past 4 or 5 weeks, it's above and beyond that. It's beyond the knowledge, the work, the abilities, the theologies, and the belief. It's a state of God being, a state of dream being, where our souls are no longer something we listen to, but something that we are. Place your hand on your heart again. I want you to feel that, the unique, beautiful expression of music that you are, that maybe you have forgotten. Maybe you never heard it before. What we do here in this community is call you forth. Call that symphony forth. Is there a time, I know we've all tasted it, where we were no longer listening to the music or the prayers of God, the theologies of God, the ideas and visions of a dream, and suddenly they lived within us at such a deep place, they were already made manifest. That's what we do here. As I examine my life on this planet, I've had moments of bliss. How many people have ever had a moment where you just knew that you knew that you knew that you knew that all was right with the world? Fleeting moment, the high meadow, whatever it is, it's like everything's okay. It makes no sense. You might still have arthritis in our human condition. You might still be wound tight in our human condition, but there is a moment of awareness when you listen to a music so beautiful, so pure, so sweet, so profound that you knew in that second everything was okay. I want seconds to become minutes. We're here doing the work that minutes become hours, and hours become weeks, and weeks become our new expression, a new paradigm. I've had moments where I felt like my grandmother listening to Chopin in the silence. No sermons, no lessons. And it was usually that happened right before something was about to break through, break open, break free. And that something usually was me. Had nothing to do with what was in the outer realm. Nothing to do with the vision being out here or in here. It had everything to do with me listening to that music of God that chose at the beginning of my life to express as me. You know, music is vibration, right? We all know that. Dreams, they're vibration as well. God is nothing more than a vibration. Not a personality-centric energy that's blessing or cursing people. It's just a vibration. And we tune into that vibration. We tune into that frequency, and we begin to listen. Listen beyond what our ears hear. See beyond what our eyes can see. I've had those moments. All of us are vibration. Everything is music. Say that with me. Everything is music. Say it like you mean it. Everything is music. Each one of us is like a string on a piano. A lot of strings on a piano. Some of those strings feel dissonant. Sometimes they go out of tune. Sometimes they are resonant in harmony. Sometimes it's complete and total unison. And sometimes it feels like tension. But any musician worth their weight will tell you that tension is necessary. When you're playing a beautiful piece of music, let alone Chopin, there is tension and release. Tension and release. The best composers throughout time used tension in order to make the piece more beautiful. That doesn't make any sense to the human ego. There's tension in us. I'm wound a little bit tight. There's tension in our community. We're wound a little bit tight. There's tension in our world. We're wound a little bit tight. Our job is to have a regular practice of finding the music, the harmony on the other side of the tension, the release. Take a breath with me and release. The music that is you isn't always pretty. I happen to like Rachmaninoff more than Chopin. My grandmother resonated with Chopin. I like Rachmaninoff. Rachmaninoff was probably wound really, really tight. But the reality is, each one of us is necessary for the piano, for the whole of the piano. All the strings must be working in accord, in partnership, facing the same direction. And I love to say that if one string breaks, and I was sitting in a cabaret show one time, and I was playing, it was a Jerry Herman review in San Francisco, and two strings on that piano broke in the middle of a performance. Now, I would love to say that, oh, well, it just affected those two strings, but here's the thing about a piano, and anybody who's ever looked inside a piano or tried to play a piano where a string is broken, it affects 3, 4, 5 strings all around it. The world is forever changed around that particular string, so I had to play an entire cabaret show avoiding about 10 or 12 notes. Not an easy thing to do when you're the only person in the orchestra, but the reality is that applies to our lives today. There is no private good. I've said that before, but there is no private brokenness. There is no private out-of-tuneness. So as we find the music within our own soul and listen to our own soul on our own dream, we must be aware of the person next to us, to our left, to our right, in front of us and behind us, that may be experiencing a loss of memory. I've forgotten who I am. I thought I had this piece of my soul memorized, and I have forgotten. That's what we do here. In the area of dream building, we help each other be in tune. We help each other remember when we have forgotten. Each frequency, good, dissonant, harmonious, unified, or tense, is the whole that is God. And our job as a community is in the midst of all the different sounds and experiences to attune to the frequency of the soul, to be intimate with it. At any given Sunday, you're going to maybe agree or disagree with what I'm saying from the platform. You may be doing that today. But at any given moment, beyond all that stuff, how we're supposed to hold our fingers, how we're supposed to sing correctly. You know, there's any number of people in this room that were told, because you didn't hold your fingers correctly and live the life that you were supposed to live, that you don't belong in an organization. And that's what got you here to this church. Sing your song. I've been to many churches. They told me, this is the song that you will sing, hymn number 374. And you will sing 374 or you don't belong here. Man, am I grateful that I belong to a church that says, let me sing 451 or let me sing 3 or let me just be silent and not sing anything because I don't want to sing. There's something magical about that. We're in a piano together and the world needs us. So talking about singing a different hymn, many of you don't know this, but you know, my grandmother desperately tried to get me to learn to play the piano and to have my music major in college be the piano. I made a decision to sing hymn 451, and I took up the tuba. Universal laugh about the, you know what they say, the definition of perfect pitch? It's when you throw the tuba into the dumpster and it hits the accordion. Something about the tuba spoke to my heart, and something was awakened to me within me, not just my grandmother at the piano. I went and heard Floyd Cooley. Floyd Cooley was the most famous tubist ever. And I watched this concert, and pardon me if this is offensive to you, the man made love to the tuba as a solo instrument. He had a full orchestra behind him, and I felt a vibration when he played that beautiful instrument, and it can do a lot more than oompa if you pay attention. But I realized what my soul was calling for in that moment is the same thing my soul's calling for in this community. The thing about a tuba, it's not in the front of the band. It's hardly ever in the front of the band or the orchestra. It's way in the back. It's a very private experience. Nobody's seeing you up front with the flutes and the violins and the clarinets. They're all up front. It's very private. I, as an introvert, as a very shy introvert, found my home back there. And I let Floyd Cooley live in my mind to play the tuba, and I was all of 85 pounds as a high school freshman. The tuba weighed as much as I did. You wrap your arms around that horn, and then when the air starts to move through it, let me tell you, my whole body could vibrate in a state of oneness with the tuba. I learned to make love to the tuba, which made no sense to anybody in my family. Certainly not my parents, as I took the tuba into the shower because it sounded so good in there. And I would practice my solos in the shower. Not only was I holding and feeling against my chest, my heart, a oneness with the vibration, I was feeling it all around me. That's a metaphor for what we do here. That's what we ask you to do, is to take God in God's unique form, the way that that music of God shows up as you, and to hold it close and to wrap your arms around it, not just on Sunday, but every moment. Make love to that vibration and frequency that is above and beyond the notes of our intellect and our theories. It's have an intimate relationship with God in such a way that it's vibrating your whole body as you play it. God is a tuba. Kind of strange to a lot of people. To me, my grandmother lived in me the minute I got a hold of a tuba and felt that. Take your hand and place it upon your chest once again. Feel the music. Feel it come from deep within. You gotta feel the music before the singing can begin. You gotta know that way down deep inside is where you're gonna give the music life. Feel the music, and everything will be all right. Anybody notice that there's a lot of voices happening in the world today? There's a lot of talking. There's a lot of yammering, and it's filling our heads, and it's filling our hearts, and it's like pillow being put over our collective and individual music. Every day, every moment, there are voices happening. I'm sorry to say that sometimes that voice is mine. Externally, oh, but internally. Some of those voices feel like unison. Some of them feel like dissonance. Some feel like harmony, and some feel like tension. All voices are important. Every voice is important. But at the end of the day, what is the only voice that matters? Of Course in Miracles students, I know you know this. What is the only voice that matters? Let every voice but God's be still in me now. Sabbath. Let every voice but God's be still. Feel it so close, so connected, that the whole world, certainly your world, begins to transform and soften. And suddenly the voices don't have that much power. Suddenly the tension doesn't have all that power in the world because you are so connected to that which you are, that which you have always been. And if the notes are bothering you, guess where you need to look? If the notes that somebody else are singing is bothering you, get a tuba. Get God as a tuba and embrace it and remember. And from the tuba, play Chopin melodies. Play the melody of your existence that maybe you have forgotten. Maybe somebody else next to you on the piano has been broken, and you are the very balm of Gilead needed. You are the very salve needed to heal the four or five other strings around you. My grandmother, and many of you know this story because I have shared it before, at the end of her life, Alzheimer's took her life. And I went to see her about a week before she passed. And I went to see my grandmother, and she was in a wheelchair, slumped over. It looked like the music was not there. It was gone. I tried to communicate with her, couldn't talk. So I communicated with my grandmother the only way I knew how. And there was a beat up, out of tune piano sitting over in the corner. And I went over with the sloppiest fingers, the worst Chopin ever played in the history of Chopin. But I knew it well enough that something stirred in her. She raised her hand, and we began to communicate through the music. No words were needed, although she did speak words, as she began to beat the rhythm to the song, just as she had done when I was 11 years old. And she turned and she said, "I'm responsible for this." And then it stopped. The music stopped. And I felt like I had reawakened the music that had been forgotten for just a second. But perhaps the music had never been forgotten in her. Perhaps the music was only forgotten in me when I was looking at human condition and not the beautiful Chopin that was playing underneath the surface. This is what we do here. We look beyond the surface that looks broken, that looks like a melody's been forgotten, and we reawaken it. You for me, me for you. Altogether, we remember the symphony that is God. Too many people die with their music still inside them. Too many people leave their song unheard. If there was just one gift I could give to you, it's sing your song, raise your voice, and be heard. What we do here is sacred work. And if it's a quote, I'm not sure who said it, if only the birds with the prettiest voices sang, what a boring and lonely world this would be. I've mentioned throughout this series that there are people all over the country that are living their dream, singing their song based on what they got in this room, in this space, amongst you. And one of you was like the grandmother that called you off the baseball field of life and onto a piano and introduced you to the music of your own soul. One of you was Floyd Cooley, who made love to a tuba and created a lifetime of therapy behind a piano, a tuba, a trombone, whatever it is I happen to be playing. I will never need a therapist as long as I've got the music. You are that person for somebody in this room, and I want to share as my final story as I invite the band to come back up. Valerie Hayes is a very, very good friend of mine, and she wouldn't mind the description I'm going to lay out there. Valerie Hayes was scared to death to sing. Valerie Hayes was as big around as she was tall, about that tall. Scared to death to be seen. Scared to death that somebody would see her. But she had a desire to sing, and so I invited her into a group at a religious science church that I was working for. Had a group of about 10 to 15 people, much like what you had here today. And we were singing a song, I believe it might have been a Barry Manilow song. God, forgive me. Uh-oh, I've touched a nerve. And there was a line at the end of the piece. A solo line. It was all about one voice. One voice makes a difference. One voice can change the world. And there was maybe a six-word, one-phrase solo at the end of that piece. And I said, "Valerie, I want you to do that." Her eyes were as big as she was tall and round. "I can't do this. I can't be out front standing in front of people. They'll be looking at me. I'm okay being in a group. And I can't sing. My voice will shake. And my voice will crack." And I said, "It might. But you've got all the rest of us here behind you as your voice shakes and your voice cracks." She did it. She did the solo in front of the packed house, two services. Was it perfect? Not even close. Was it what she would become? Not even close. But something happened in that moment, in that church, that happens in this church. Long story short, Valerie Hayes now is requested at every church on the West Coast to come and sing and to share her music. She is in demand. She's filled up for months at a time to be the soloist at these church services and has been asked to do cabaret shows on Friday and Saturday nights. ground, not by the world's view, the best song in the world suddenly is in demand. She sings from a place. How many know Sonia Osio? Sonia Osio can open her mouth, and sometimes it cracks and it warbles, but where does it come from? Her voice, Valerie's voice, Lloyd Cooley's voice, the music of Chopin is no more profound than the music that is you. And sometimes we're a little rough around the edges. I'm proud to be part of a church that's a little rough around the edges. Ryan, you can put a little music behind me. That would be great. I'm blessed to have been somebody who called out the music of Valerie Hayes. I take a little bit of credit for that moment. But I stand here today with a long line of people as a shy, introverted kid who wanted to hide in the back of the band, had ulcers at middle school with piano recitals, who found Chopin. Well, I didn't find Chopin. I found Scott Joplin. I resonated with Scott Joplin, not Chopin, much to my grandmother's chagrin. But I found that which spoke to me, a vibration as pure and sweet, whether it be playing the tuba or the piano or standing before a group of people with my knees knocking, going, I've got something to say, and I want to pay it forward. I'm going to invite the choir to come back up and to gather behind me. This is the foundation. My grandmother called the music out of me. Floyd Cooley called the music out of me. I invite you to speak the name right now of somebody who called music out of you, a song that you did not know existed, a dream that you didn't know was possible. Call their name out right now. Say it. And here's the most beautiful part. You pay it forward. We're on this ladder of existence all becoming together. You were that somebody. You were that Floyd Cooley for somebody. And somebody's life is forever changed as they're invited all over the West Coast to sing. Speak the name of those people you have touched at depth right now. Don't be shy. Your song is needed. Your awareness of your magnificence is needed. It's a part of the song. Here's my final prayer, and we're going to go into meditation. Hold your music close like a tuba. Sing through your fears. Sing even if you don't think you're the prettiest voice or the prettiest song or the prettiest dream in the room. Sing if you have forgotten and have spiritual Alzheimer's. Sing if you've forgotten yourself 1,000 times. Sing and let every voice but God's as you be still in you. Create sacred Sabbath. Create sacred silence and feel the very vibration of God as your song, as your dream, as your calling, as your soul. You gotta know that way down deep inside, where you give the music life. Feel the music and everything will be all right. I invite you to take another deep breath. We're going to go into the meditation now. It's not going to be a lot of words, just a lot of feelings, so keep that hand on that heart. The song is I feel the music in me as I sing a song of remembrance. I invite you, once we've done it a couple times, to sing it with us. And as I do, all my dreams come true.
I feel the music in me.
the music continues, I invite you to breathe deeply. And know together as a collective in this now moment that you were born to change the world. You were born to change the strings, maybe three or four to the left or the right, above and beyond. And you are here for a divine purpose. You are not an accident. You are here to be the light of the world. And maybe you've forgotten 1,000 times. Today, let's remember. And let's remember together. Feel that inner metronome of God. Maybe a hand raised, beating out time. An instruction that taught you how to hold your hands or how to do it correctly. Let it all go. And choose the song that is yours. Choose the dream that is yours. Choose the music that is you. And become so intimate with it, so connected to it, to its vibration, that God happens, not through you. God happens as you, a vibrating cell within the body of the symphony that is life itself. The entire cosmos alive with the vibration of love and remembrance. An entire earth alive as lives are touched by the vibration that you bring, the song that you share, the music that you are. As we fall into the silence, I invite you once again, if you're not doing so already, to place your hand upon your heart and to know your worth and your value. To know your purpose. You were designed in the image and after the likeness of music itself. Feel it. Feel it deep within. In the silence. Let every voice but God's be still in me now. Let every voice but love be still in me now. And in a state of oneness, one piano, one God, you are Inez Burdick. You are Floyd Cooley. You are Valerie Hayes. You are that string or that person to your left or your right. We belong to each other. Feel that music and don't wait one more day to share it and to sing it. I invite you to join us in singing these words one more time.
As I sing the
last 4 weeks, we've asked you to invest in this community and to invest in the collective and the individual dreams. Today was a slow coming into home, the end of our series. A new one will start next week. But at the end of the day, with all that's been shared for 5 weeks, if you get nothing else, the changing of lives as people learn that they have value and worth and their song must be sung, that's what we're investing in. If you have not had an opportunity to sign up for the consistent giving program yet, as a part of where we are going as a collective, that we reach more people and more music is heard, I'm going to invite you to see our staff in the foyer at the end of the service today. But nothing brings me more pleasure than sitting at the front of the orchestra with you all, playing a tuba in the front of the band, but knowing that we're playing the same song together. And so it is, and so it shall be. It's time for our offering. We're going to invite you, to those of you online, to find a way to say thank you. We're reaching out and doing everything we can to give you the very best product online and to reach out and to make sure that we're connected wherever you may be, in Georgia, in California, Texas, New York, and Florida. Your contributions are allowing us to continue to do that. Those of you in the room, we're not passing the baskets anymore. I think that's an old song. The baskets are there. Don't walk out without saying at least a blessing and offering something to say thank you, because I found my music here. Text in church is a very easy way to do it for you, those of you in the room as well as online. Text 73 to that number, 73256. It's very simple. Once you've done it once, it takes about 10 seconds to do it again. We thank you for your generosity. We thank you for the love that you bring to this community and you share with this community. Right now, we have a closing song that from the hymnal, number 374 of the Doobie Brothers hymnal. And I bet you probably know it. And I thought nobody better to sing this than Michael March, as we put an exclamation point on this series about dreams and visions. And so get your whoa, 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 listen to the music in gear. Feel free to stand up and sing with us as we take this chorus out into the world. Michael, it's all yours.
Tessa. Don't you feel it growing day by day? People are getting ready for the news. Some are happy, some are sad. Yeah, come on, let that music play. Oh yeah, come on, join it. What the people need is a way to make them smile. It ain't hard to do if you know how. Gotta get a message, get it on through, yeah. Don't you ask me why. Whoa, 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 listen to the music. Whoa, 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 listen to the music. Whoa, whoa, listen to the music. All the thing I say, meet me in the country for a day. We'll be happy, yeah, and we'll dance. Come on, dance our blues away. If I'm feeling good to you and you're feeling good to me, there ain't nothing we can do or say. Feeling good, feeling fine. Lazy flowing river, surrounding castles in the sky. The crowd is growing bigger, Listen to the happy sound. We got to let them fly. Whoa, whoa. Listen to the music. Whoa, whoa.
Community. This is why you're investing. No, not Julie. Right here. This is why you're investing. Kids who have not forgotten the song. Kids who are here to remind us of the song. Go out into the world and say, yes, whoa, 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 listen to my music. Whoa, 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 the Christ is alive. Parents are going to get your kids over there on the left, but I think we got two more choruses in it, right? Sing it like you've never sung before in your life. Let's kick this in. One, two, three. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Listen to the music. Grab a tuba and play Chopin. Beautiful day and week to you. Happy Halloween, everybody. Thanks for coming.